Dear students, Salaam Alaikum. Now we have come to the last chapter of Math 103B, and this chapter is about differentiation with simple applications. Today we shall learn to differentiate very simple function. Now there are two grammatical words, differentiation and derivative. They are interrelated, so both are similar for you. Differentiation is adjective, the action, and derivative is the outcome. Now, what is derivative of a function? See, we have done straight lines. See, the straight lines have a fixed slope, which we call y equal to mx plus c, where m is the slope and c is the y-intercept. So the derivative is all about slopes. Now how do you write a derivative of a function? We write f prime x. There is a comma after f towards the upper right hand side. It is called f prime x. This comma in mathematics is called prime. F prime x. Or we also write dy by dx, or we also write df by dx. Now what's the derivative? Derivative is a slope. Now in this graph, you can see the slope is changing from point to point. So in case of straight lines, the slope is fixed for every line, but for all other curves other than straight line, the slope keeps changing. It can become negative, it can become zero, it can become positive. Now look, here the slope is positive, here also positive, here positive, but very high, medium, low, and here it is zero because it is horizontal. The straight line is horizontal. Now how do you write the derivative of a function? We write it as dy by dx and read it as dy by dx. It is not a fraction, it is a style of writing. Now we shall learn to differentiate the power function. What is a simple function? If f of x equal to x power n, then the derivative f prime x equal to n into x power n minus 1. So what is happening is, this is your function x power n, and the derivative is n into x power n minus 1. The power becomes less by 1 and this number comes down. So you bring the power down. Look, you bring the power n down like this and subtract 1 from the power. So this is the function, this is the derivative. Now let's do an example. F of x equal to x square. Then f prime x equal to 2 into x power 2 minus 1. How much is n? N is 2. 2 minus 1 is 1. So x power 2. 2 into x power 2 minus 1. The power comes down and here you subtract in the power. 2 minus 1 is 1. There is no need to write 1. So 2 into x power 1 equal to 2x. Here the power is 15. N equal to 15. N minus 1 is 15 minus 1, which is equal to 14, and the power comes down. So the derivative of x power 15 is 15 into x power 14. Now let's do another example. X power minus 3. How much is n? Minus 3. It is not 3, it is minus 3. N equal to minus 3. Minus 3 minus 1 is minus 4. And the power comes down. So the power is how much? Minus 3. And after it subtraction, it becomes minus 4. So your function is x power minus 3 and the derivative is minus 3 into x power minus 4. Now here it is. Next question. 1 divided by x power 6. Remember your indices. It is x power minus 6. So the function is x power minus 6. Here it was x power minus 3. Minus 6 will come down, bring down the power. Minus 6 minus 1 is minus 7. So the derivative is minus 6 into x power minus 7. Now differentiate these questions. We'll discuss them again in the class. Now the power can be a fraction, x power 3 by 2. How much is n? 3 by 2. 3 by 2 minus 1 is 3 by 2. How much is 1? 1 is equal to 2 by 2. 3 by 2 minus 1 is 3 by 2 minus 2 by 2, which is 1 by 2. And the power is 3 by 2, which comes down. We are going to use only one rule in this chapter today. 3 by 2 into x power half is your derivative. Now, look at this. F of x equal to 5th root of x power 8. So what's the rule? Nth root of x power m is equal to x power m by n. Now here it m is 8, n is 5. So this function is x power 8 by 5. If you don't want to write it in this symbol, change it to this. You'll get x power 8 by 5. So 8 by 5 will come down. 8 by 5 minus 1 is 8 by 5 minus 5 by 5, which is 3 by 5. You can take help of your calculators if you need to. So the function is 5th root of x power 8, which is equal to x power 8 by 5. This is your algebra. Now the derivative is 8 by 5 into x power 3 by 5. Now here the power is minus 3 by 5. Minus 3 by 5 will come down. Minus 3 by 5 minus 1 is minus 8 by 5. So this is your function and this is your derivative. So the function is x power minus 3 by 5 and the derivative is minus 3 by 5 into x power minus 8 by 5. Now this question is similar. We'll discuss it in the class again. Now do these practice questions in your home. We'll discuss them in the class. If you have any questions, ask me. Now the constant function means f of x equal to a number. Now what is the graph of this function? One straight line, horizontal line. If the number is positive, the line will be up. If the number is negative, the line will be below the x-axis. If the number is zero, it is the x-axis itself. Now the derivative of a constant function is zero. Derivative of 100 is 0, derivative of pi by 2 is 0. Do not calculate pi by 2. It is 3.1415 divided by 2. It is some number, you don't have to calculate. Derivative of all numbers, big number, small number, negative number, positive number is 0 when you differentiate it. So the derivative of 10 power 3 square root is, 10 power 3 square root is a number. Now don't calculate the number, the derivative of all numbers is 0. If the number is big, number is small, number is 0, negative, it is 0. Now let's look at a function where you are multiplying a number outside to the x power n. For example, 10 into x power 4. This is your question. Now you want to differentiate. Now don't look at the 10. You just differentiate x power 4. The derivative is 4 into x power 4 minus 1. This 10 is outside. Just leave it there. 10 into 4, 40, 4 minus 1 is 3, so derivative is 40 into x power 3. Let me repeat. Your question is 10 into x power 4, n is 4, n minus 1 is 3, this 4 is the power which comes down, so 10 into 4 is 40, you'll get 40 into x power 3, power 3 has a name called cube, it is 40x cube. Another example of this type. Minus 4 divided by x square. Now first do one little bit of algebra. Your question should look like the formula which you have. There is only one formula. Minus 4. This x power 2 will become x power minus 2. Now keep the minus 4 in the bracket here. Don't look at it. First look at the function. N is minus 2. The power comes down. Minus 2 minus 1 is minus 3. Minus 4 multiply with minus 2. You will get plus 8 into x power minus 3 as the final answer. See, before you do any differentiation, you have to do some algebra. this line, your differentiation is only one line. The last line is algebra. Now let us look at this example. F of x equal to mx, then the derivative will be, derivative of x is 1. So m into 1 is m. What's the derivative of 6x in the example? 6 into 1, 6. Derivative of 5 by 2x is 5 by 2 into 1 is 5 by 2. Now derivative of x by 3 is 1. The derivative of x is 1. The 3 is outside, 1 by 3. So when you differentiate the line y equal to mx, the x will go away and you'll be left with m, which is the slope of the line. Now do these derivatives in this slide. Go home and do it. We'll discuss them in the next class. Again, here there is a set of exercises which you have to do. Now this is one example which we are going to do in the class. Now first take the function f of x equal to minus 8 x power 4 plus 3 divided by 4th root of x power 5 minus 20 cube plus 4 by x. Now, in the first line, do the algebra. The first one is written normally, minus 8 x power 4 plus 3 x power minus 5 by 4. Do not calculate this number, minus 20 cube plus 4 x power minus 1. This x, when it goes up, it will become x power minus 1. Now this line has your differentiation. 4 is the power n equal to 4. So 4 x power 3, 4 into 8 is 32. So minus 2, 32 into x power 3. Minus 3, now the power is minus 5 by 4. So this minus plus into minus will come here. Minus 5 by 4 minus 1 is, we'll do in the next line, which is minus 9 by 4. Now derivative of a number is 0, so you can write 0 in this step, or there is no need to write. Do not calculate this number, derivative of all numbers is 0. Now x power minus 1, n equal to minus 1. So 4 into minus 1 is minus 4, x power minus 2. Now the last step is your algebra. You can write it as minus 9 by 4 and minus 2. So nothing is happening. This line is kind of extra, but you are just simplifying this line. Your differentiation is only one line, rest all is algebra. Now do this example on your own. We'll discuss it in the class. Thank you for your listening.